week, Lack and the CEO of NBC Universal, Steve Burke, were given a secret briefing about the almost three-month-long internal investigation into Brian Williams' alleged embellishments. You remember how he said he was on a helicopter hit by an RPG in Iraq, but was actually on a different chopper. And then how questions came up about the claim that he received a souvenir from SEAL Team 6, and whether he really saw a dead body floating outside his hotel in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. All of those stories have been known, but there are other ones as well. All told, the investigators have found at least 10 instances of exaggerations or embellishments by Williams. According to sources who have spoken with me and with other news outlets, this may not be over yet. The investigation continues to go on. So let me bring in Washington Post media reporter Paul Farhi, who broke some of this news yesterday. Paul, I had to have you here because you scooped me twice this week. You've been all over this story. And I want to know what you think the significance is of the fact that this investigation is not over yet. I mean, we heard about this internal investigation back in February. It's been going on and on and on. And NBC is indicating it still hasn't finished.
Yeah, I think they are looking for more, but I would say substantially it's over. The main stuff has come out and they are aware of it. They've turned up a couple of things that we who reported this back when Williams was first suspended weren't aware of. There was one incident in Egypt that we weren't aware of. So I think substantially it's over, but you know, there is maybe a little bit more to come. They want to keep their options open, get the full bill of particulars.
Tell us about the Tahrir Square example. This is the new one we learned about a couple of days ago.
Right. Well, Brian Williams went and covered the Arab Spring uprisings in Tahrir Square in Egypt, in Cairo, back in 2011, and described seeing pro-government forces on horseback coming into the square to beat people with whips. And he says he made eye contact with the lead horseman in this brigade. It's unclear whether or not he actually was there to see what he said he saw. There's doubt raised in this internal investigation within NBC whether he was actually truthful about that.
So when your story came out on Saturday, these are the kind of text messages that I received from people at NBC. Is Brian Williams done? It sure sounds like the groundwork is being laid to push him out of NBC. It's awkward to talk about sourcing in situations like this, but do you think that all of these leaks is part of an effort to lay the groundwork for him to leave?
I do, and I do believe that at least they are raising the temperature so that NBC, if it's thinking about bringing him back, will do so against a big barrage of bad PR. You know, I don't know, frankly, whether he's coming back or not, but it is clear that he has plenty of enemies within NBC who would like to see him retired at this point. And that's what the totality of these leaks is really all about, is poisoning the ground so that if NBC was thinking about it, they will do so up against a very tall barrier to getting him back in the anchor chair.